Today, we are making some vegan fried chicken using seitan, and these are so dang easy, delicious, and crunchy. And I even have a few tips for frying that should make it even easier and crunchier, so let's get it going. Now this seitan is going to start off with some vital wheat gluten naturally. We'll also be using an entire can of chickpeas, and it's worth noting that this recipe was inspired by my friend Lacey over at Avocados and Ales, link in description for her world famous recipe. So let's dump an entire can of chickpeas and the aquafaba juice into a bowl. Then of course by law we'll add in 2 tablespoons of nutritional yeast, aka nooch, 2 tablespoons of mushroom seasoning. If you can't find this, just use more nooch. And then 1 tablespoon of vegan chicken powder. Again, if you can't find this, don't worry about it. 1 teaspoon of garlic and onion powder. 1/2 teaspoon of liquid smoke. 1 tablespoon of apple cider vinegar. And then 2 sloppy tablespoons of a neutral oil. And now in another bowl, we're going to get 180 grams of our vital wheat gluten. And now we're going to blend up everything but the vital wheat gluten in a food processor, and once it's smooth after a minute or two, add in the vital wheat gluten, and then we're going to want to blend this for a few minutes as well. And here's the texture after a minute or so, and if you're like me and the dough ball feels a bit soft and wet, add in some more vital wheat gluten, so I'm going to do 2 more tablespoons, and then just keep blending, and if your food processor sounds or smells like it's having a hard time, then you might need to split the dough in half and do it in 2 sessions. But either way, you just want to blend this up until you have something that looks like this. You really want to see those strands of gluten. That's what's going to give us that meaty texture. Make sure you don't overknead it either. You want to find that Goldilocks zone, usually between 5 to 8 minutes. And once your seitan loaf is looking good, let it rest for about 15 to 20 minutes. And now you can seam this as one big loaf and shred it. That's what Lacey does in her recipe. But since we're making sandwiches, I'm going to break off some pieces that weigh around 125 grams each. And then I'm going to roll them into fillets like so. And try to get these as thin as possible. One thing I don't like is biting into a thick old piece of fried seitan. I want maximum crunch, so the thinner the better. And I got 6 fillets from this batch, and make sure to keep a couple of little pieces like this. They will come in handy later. I'm going to show you a nice little trick. Next, we need to wrap these guys up in some foil. You can wrap them first in parchment paper, or you can even use cheesecloth, I believe. You just want to wrap them tight so they don't expand too much and become spongy. And once all your seitan fillets are wrapped, we're going to get an Instant Pot and add a steamer tray, and then some water, of course, and we're just going to steam these on high pressure for 1 hour and 20 minutes. You can steam this on the stovetop, but the Instant Pot will give you a slightly better texture in my experience. And 1 hour and 20 minutes later, do a quick release. Make sure you do the seitan dance to get the best possible texture as well. And then once the Instant Pot is done letting off some steam, take out the fillets and let them cool down. And once they're okay to handle, unwrap them, and that's what they should look like, something like that. And now we just need to make a vegan buttermilk marinade. So let's get 2 cups of unsweetened plant milk, 2 tablespoons of dill pickle brine, 2 tablespoons of your favorite hot sauce, and then 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar. And then I'm just gonna use this to season it, but use whatever you like. I think I probably added about 1 tablespoon's worth or so. And then whisk that up, and then add that to a container with your seitan chicken fillets and let that marinate for at least 4 hours, but overnight is best. The next day, we'll take out our fillets, and then we'll use that leftover marinade for our dredging station. And now something you can do if your marinade is thin is just add a little flour to thicken it up. This little trick will really help with a nice crunchy breading. I'm just going to add a couple tablespoons and whisk it in. So let's put together our dry dredge now, and this is quite simple. We're just going to use equal parts flour and cornstarch. I'm going to do a cup of each. And another important ingredient is baking powder. This is going to use science to make your breading super craggly and amazing, so don't skip it. So we're going to do 2 tablespoons of that. And now for seasoning, do whatever you like, but I've been digging this Creole seasoning by Tony Chachere, or however you say it, so 2 tablespoons of that as well. Black pepper, and now mix that up. And now let's get some neutral flavored oil with a high smoke point like peanut, vegetable, or canola and add that to a pan. And make sure you don't go over halfway. And normally I would use something with taller walls, but this is better for filming. And we're going to heat that up to 375 degrees Fahrenheit or 190 degrees Celsius. To coat and dredge our vegan chicken, simply take it and first dump it in the flour and really make sure you coat it thoroughly and really pat it into the fillet. Shake off the excess and you can fry it like this, or you can double dredge it. So back into the wet, let the excess drip off, and then back into the dry for a double thick batter. Now remember those little nuggets I had you make earlier? Go ahead and dredge and fry those. This way you can see if the seasoning needs any adjusting. Mine was perfect, so I added in the big fillet, and you just want to fry these for about 4 to 5 minutes or until nicely browned. If you're going to flip them, do so carefully using another utensil so you don't splash hot oil everywhere and burn yourself. That's not fun. And once the chicken is looking good, let it rest on a wire rack so it doesn't steam itself and get soggy. And yes, you can air fry this if you wanted to. I'll leave instructions in the blog post. And now all we gotta do is plate up a sandwich. For sauces, I'm gonna try out this new Nashville hot sauce by Frank's that I found. I'm also gonna throw together a dill mayo sauce by getting some vegan mayo, adding a bit of some dill pickle brine, and then more of that garlic seasoning. And I gotta say, for slapping this together, it was super dang good. Like, I could drink it. That's how delicious it was. So we're gonna get a toasted bun, some of that delicious dill mayo, some drippy drips, of course, and then some dill pickles, our vegan fried chicken, and then a nice drizzle of that Nashville hot sauce, and then the top bun. And I gotta say, that first bite, man, that was so dang good. I'll admit the breading does the heavy lifting, but that's not a bad thing in my book. The seitan is good, of course. It has a great chew and a savory chicken-like taste, but that breading really is the star of the show, which is how I remember traditional fried chicken, so I guess it works. Now the Nashville sauce, it was okay, but honestly, the Nashville hot chicken sandwich recipe I got in my new cookbook was way better. And in fact, this seitan recipe can be used as a base for a bunch of the fried chicken recipes in the book too. And I have an entire section that goes into more detail about vegan fried chicken. So if you haven't already, please pre-order my book. It comes out in 2 days. Thank you. And until then, check out this video for some McNuggets that I got too. And I'll see you all next time.